Spoiler warning, guys. If you don't want to hear my movie review since you haven't seen this movie in local cinema, then leave. But anyways, welcome back again to another YouTube video. So I promise I'm gonna record something different. It's gonna be a movie review that I just saw earlier at a movie cinema called If. So yeah, I just got back from the hotel after I saw the movie in the cinema since the past 3 hours ago. I decided not to pick up my phone to record a video right when I got back here after the movie theater because I wasn't in a good mood anymore, but everything's good, you know, I'm feeling much better. So anyways, so then let's say this. So we're gonna talk about the movie If, which I saw in the movie theaters. Yes, I know it came out yesterday, but yeah, my brother and I saw it, and as well as my mother. So yeah, it's a live action animated fantasy comedy movie, and directed by John Krasinski. And this film features a simple cast members such as Kelly Fleming, Ryan Reynolds, Alan Kim, Steve Carell, blah blah blah. And it's released by Paramount, which I thought this movie's released by Universal Entertainment, but no, it was released in Paramount, so sorry. But anyways, the plot of this movie stars a 12-year-old girl named B, so it's B-A-A, not the letter B. She moved into her grandmother Margaret's apartment in New York while her father waits for heart surgery in the same hospital where her mother died of cancer years later. One night, B goes out to buy a charger for her mother's old camcorder and sees a strange creature following it back to her grandmother's building. The next day, she sees a creature again accompanied by the man. A bee follows him to the nearby house where the man, Cal, retrieves a large purple creature named Blue, who's voiced by Steve Carell. And she also meets the other creature of a butterfly-like named Blossom and faints. She awakens by Cal's apartment where she learns that he's been working with imaginary friends nicknamed Ifs to place him with new children and the original children have grown up and forgotten them. And B ended up helping Cal. The next day, Cal takes B to Memory Lane retirement company for Ifs, house underneath a merry-go-round in Coney Island, New York, which is where my dad took me there last summer. He introduces B to Lewis, an elderly teddy bear who is the head of the faculty. He aspires B to use their imagination and redesign the faculty, much to the chagrin of Cal, after running down the hallways, winds up in the music video of Tina Turner's Better Be Good to Me. What a great song. And they ended up running on stage and dancing. I mean, this is the greatest movie scene ever. Spoiler warning! Motivated by a young boy named Benjamin that she met at the hospital, and B tries to match one the Ifs with him. And she and Cal and Lewis auditioned Ifs, including most of the animals. I can't tell you the names, sorry. And sadly, he's not able to see them. Talking with her grandmother, she sees a picture of a young dancer and recognizes Blossom in the background of the picture. Realizing Blossom with the grandmother If, B decides that he is the best course of action does reunite with Ifs with their original kids. Playing one of her grandmother's records aspires Margaret to dance as she remembers Blossom, instilling B with hope. Following a tip, they find Blue's original kid, Jeremy, now a grown man trying to launch a business. Though her intentional attempt fails, B and Cal succeed in reminding Jeremy of Blue and reuniting them, giving Jeremy the confidence that he needs to nail a presentation. When B returns home that evening, however, Margaret is frantic and tells Bea something went wrong with her father's operation. Bea rushes up those stairs to Cal, comforts her. When Bea says she doesn't want to say goodbye to her dad, Cal tells him a story instead. At the hospital, Bea tells her father of how she tried to be a grown-up, but her father kept trying to bring fun in her life, and that she still needs him, which wake him up. And that part of the movie scene is so emotional. That's all I could think of. My mother ended up crying, as well as a few people who were very emotional. I know. Yeah. But spoiler warning. No spoilers here. Watch your movie yourself. Bea goes tells her grandmother and realizes that ifs have vanished. After being released from the hospital, Bea and her dad pack up to go back home. Bea goes upstairs to say goodbye to Cal, but no one answers the door. The landlady hears Bea knocking and reveals the door opens to an old storage room. While packing her things in the car, Bea finds an old picture she painted for her parents and the clown named Calvin, and she suddenly realizes that Cal is an if and her own if forgotten after the death of her mother. She closes her eyes and remembers restoring the ability to see ifs and united with Cal. And my fucking god, this is it, folks. I've watched a full movie ever, and believe me, this movie is incredible. Yeah, really great movie to watch. So yeah, pretty darn perfect to me. So that's kind of cool. It's kind of cool looking, honestly. So for the content on here, this movie looks interesting. I watched all the way through. I liked it. I rated probably 7 out of 10 star rating. And yes, I would like to get that DVD when it comes out in the near future. And I'll film DVD update video of that, I promise. But yeah, comment down below if you want to go see the movie. If you skip that part into the end, so I mean, it's the greatest movie ever, so I wanted to thank everyone for the love and support of how we watch a whole movie from start to finish. And we always make sure to give this video a like and subscribe for more videos. And so, with that all said, hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll see you in the next video. Dobin said yes.